though, strolling up in the lumber mill over here. X-Stat repositioning just a little earlier than them. Nico trying to clutch this one up right now.
Ooh, Blade's doing a good job, though, getting the shots back. Jachi's already down, dodging, weaving with the leans and the peaks. Flash is going to come out to help back them up. One kill already going to the way of X-Set. That was, of course, on the player from Nova. Nice nade, though, from the Blade. Oh, my goodness. Cutting right through the defenses of X-Set. As Killswitch is up here on the high ground with the Uzi. Flash is going to drop. X-Set loses one, but they want to make sure, dang it, their opponents lose more.
Uzi! They call him the Blade. I call him the Grenade. The thing is, both of these squads, they need to worry because I see Nova rolling up. Nova are thirsty. They're looking to make the come up here today. The third party potential, that could be it for Nova.
Absolutely, especially considering they already lost one player to X-Set. They don't want to make it have any more. But with the nades coming in from Juicy, the sick play on the high ground, X-Set will hold on a little bit longer.
19E wishing they had that smoke tunnel they had last night. Not going to be the case over here. Sam, see you later, son. Ghost Gaming, they are not going to allow you to breach their compound. Juicy, now put under fire, trying to survive. That snake in the grass says the unnamed casually strolling up, wiping out Mazexus.
Will he deny himself to the blue as well, or will he go down swinging? But that's the opening, the opportunity that Ghost Gaming needs. He does deny himself to the zone. The perfect Apex Predator up there on the outside. And just like that, Ghost Gaming, they smell blood in the water as well. They've got those aggressive genes, and they're looking to put the pins to the unnamed. Nice counterplay, though. We're running out in the open. This could be huge. Hang on a second, though, Dave. They're trading back and forth. This looks like it's going to be a 1v1 situation. It all comes down to this. Bucky, can he get it done? Bayo is there in the back. Tensa is there as well. And they're all going up to try and scout and get as much intel as possible. Dave, this is a 1v1.
The Bucky versus Bayo here. The Bucky crawling up. Tensa has the intel. Tensa's crawling. Tensa's like, he's right here. He's right here. The grenade from the Bucky!
There's a lot of teams now that have congregated here towards the center. EFC, of course, being one of them. The unnamed coming in as well. Not flying under the radar this time, Dave. It's Bucky looking to continue to keep up the pressure that we saw last time. Jason's here as well. And EFC are dropping like flies as they are getting crushed one after the other. The vehicle explosions continue to back it up. It all comes down to Coops on the right side of your screen. Just trying to hold on, survive, get the first aid off. Tommy gun in hand. What can they do? Hide in a corner. And they're not spotted. No, they come back around. And just like that, the unnamed going absolutely huge. EFC out in 16th place.
Now Brain going to be getting chunked down, not only from the Molly, but also the blue zone. 19E going to be gatekeeping Syndicate down there below, keeping them pinned down as Carnage, Papa Carnage popping up over here, getting some nice shots. Nice shots. There goes the Knights.
And just like that, there were two rad in a 1v3 situation, but more like one and done. And just like that, 19 Esports pick up that winner, winner, chicken dinner. If you're going to take a fight, try and take one on your own terms. Memory's position is confirmed. Ultron on the outside, though. And what memory? Okay. Able to find those M4 shots. I can't believe it. Ultron drops. And this is the opening, the opportunity. The rest of Nova are rotating in. They have themselves a bite. They're trying to take the outside. Beast could be the one to set it all on fire as he peeks over. He's got to get involved in the fight, Dave. He's got to get involved because Nova are just steamrolling level X.
So good. That's what they need. That is what they need. Carnage double E though, connecting on Sheepman, trying to get the confer with the barrel. Rin really low in the health department. And you have to remember, this is early game. The med situation, the armor, everything is going to be trash. So Carnage double E looking to pull up, square up with Memory right now.
Memory is standing guard, letting the rest of the team try and reset here. Running through the doorways, a bit of a choke. Level X taking advantage of it for now. Nova and crew are weak. They're damaged and taken out. Beast finally gets into the fight. It may have been a little too late to save his teammates, but not too late to get the kills.
South is going to still be here. We see G3 all the way out there looking to make some type of play on that off angle. A knock coming out from the Knights. From JCR, now they're making the push.
I love this. I love this play from JCR. And a nice nade from Bishop will end up connecting the... Oh my goodness, don't throw where they were. Throw where they're going to be. Bishop leveling up like Jedi levels of sensitivity right there. What is that? The foresight to get that nade off. His teammates are going to bleed out all around him. But still creating a bit of space for himself. The question is, Dave, can he do anything with it?
You know what? 1v4. They got to pull out the card. This is the game. This is the moment to pull out the card. We saw last game, Bishop with the 360 flicks. Can they do it? SOFM. Oh, you got four guns looking in your direction. Yeah, that's going to be a tough one. So now they're going to start to make the move. So Lazarus, they have two up, sixless, Rulkiss. The unnamed have Jason. So we'll get back to that one because Sleepless, oh. Grenade. Kill switch, J7, still alive, able to defend their little shack. Ghost, though, also Bail, Tensa, Tommy Gun Tensa, trying to take this shack from Mexet. They're trying to get this cover for themselves, and the Molly?
There's a good chance he could outlive a few more.
That's what the hope is. That is what the hope is, and... Ooh, Jet G, spot out Nemesis, going for the second one, but the third party from Tensa, from downtown.
A hit list is here, JCR is out, and just like that, there were three. I said Jay might be able to outlast a few more, and Dave, it was more than a few. All three players that he had to contend with, and we called Ghost Gaming's position. We said they had the high ground, the angle, the impetus, the shots, and oh boy, did they deliver. Ghost Gaming... didn't have a chicken dinner quite yet so far on the day, Dave. They got pretty close. But let's make it three. The first team to three. Chicken dinner to Ghost Gaming.
And Lazarus coming into play, getting a knock onto the hit list. Lazarus definitely one of the aggressive teams, and they're going hard in. Sixless with the second one. It's a 2v4 situation now. And it's not looking good for the hit list. They get bait. Bait could get thirsted here. That is not good. Sixless is the only player up here so far to try and recover this situation. Bait does get thirsted.
Oh man, Fate shouldn't have ran in there by himself. I mean, I think that was a little bit of a misplay. Now they have to deal with three. They are going to be able to use each other, though. This is what they should have done a little bit earlier. Sixless does get knocked. Trickster still up, jumped out the building. He's going to 1v1 this, and yes, gets caught out.
And now JCR, we're continuing the fight between JCR and Xset. Xset losing one member, getting Juicy.
Oh, Juicy! This Juicy!
Four kills right there. Juicy.
A DP.
Got the full squad wipe. I love this play out of Ghost. It's proactive. Like, they have zone. They could have sat in the back and just chilled. But they know if they want to win the rest of this match, they got to go aggressive. Now, Passion Fruits with a great defense, grenade back. It's a knock on each side. It's a full out push. Beowulf goes down. Passion Fruits going down too. Oh, it's a mess. It's down to HH and Spec, and it's just Juancho up, and they get that wipe.
Baby.
Ghost Gaming. And now it's down to 19E, level X, and the unnamed. Now Chuno, oh, he's forced to shoot at that.
Oh,
for that thirst. A little bit to the left, and there we go. A play, not placement point, but a kill point. And it comes down to these three teams. TU versus 19E. 19E, is it just a solo? It's two solos, Chuno and,
And he got Carnage. He saw him earlier, took his sweet time, and now he's gonna go out. So he gets the placement point, but also 10 placement points and the kill as well. Now, oh my goodness, Jason just running straight in. It's Acer
clutches
with the Uzi.
Acer could do this.
Oh, he can.
Oh, the panic.
Here comes that Uzi.
Panic out of TU. They're panicking right now.
Oh, he has to switch to M16! The M16 ain't gonna do it!
And we got a fight already breaking out between the hit list and Xset, and this looks like a scramble fight. Both teams want this position. The hit list, though, they already have the high ground.
And
the off angle by Jat G. Nico already goes down. This is looking good for the hit list.
Beautiful right there. Okay, here comes Jat G coming in hot. You can see.
Oh my god, kill switch.
And he's gonna go for another one. I mean, they knew that that angle was covered, but they ran up for it. Oh yeah, they did get two knocks, and Xset. Kill switch coming up huge. They did lose Nico in the process. They're going to get this res off. But J7, I mean, this is huge for Xset.
Yeah, I literally saw kill switch when they lost their first player. Kill switch literally just ran up and 1v2'd. And so kill switch literally won this fight. And he's about to get the third one right here. Good control peaks, missing a few shots. It's fine. They take that wipe and Xset. They only lose one player.
And now, after that knock, here comes Ghost Gaming. They are full sending it on in. Xenox up front and personal with the Tommy gun. He's got all the sight lights in the world.
Oh, literally. Xenox popping off right now.
Ghost is in trouble. 1v1 Xenox. 19E though, this is all them to win this and put a massive lead above Ghost.
So now the focus is between 19E and the Knights.
I'd have 10 kills.
Lazarus is still up, and it's not just any player of Lazarus. It's Sixus. I mean, I have to hype up Sixus at this point, because every time he's so... Oh, no, it's Rokus. I'm sorry. Rokus. Oh, this is huge if he gets that knock. That's going to be huge for the Knights. They're not going to be able to get that reset, and the Knights saw that knock in the kill feed. The Knights could win this and take it out from under 19 esports.
Are they going to send it? Are they going to send it 3v2? Do they realize it? They have to know. Yeah, here comes a nice nade. They have the off angles here, so now 19E has their back up against the wall.
Slow it down, slow it down.
They calculate it. Oh, slow what down? Slow that nade down to your face. Can't do it. It's over. It is over, said the Knights.
Let's take these 4v4s. Let's get these kill points. I think we're better. We need to catch up in points, and they are going all out aggressive here. Syndicate pushing on up onto level X.
There they go. They're trying to get something happening right now. You can see Issue trying to cause level X some issues and getting... trying to get a big old knock. Ultron, that clutch player for them, completely knocked and out of position. So this is going to be a tough spot for Level X. They're going to have to make a play. Issue's running in. He's got the UMP, though. That's not the best gun to run in with. And that's why. You know, you can see right there, the Tommy gun. Oh, he's got one of his own, though. Oh, he's got the suppressed UMP. All right, getting caught back and forth. Trades going all over the place. Level X, I think, getting the worst of it. That's right. This is 1v2 situation. Oh, Beast.
Oh, 1v1.
1v1.
We're down to 1v1 between Brand.
Oh, he's got
to
send it. Oh, that's about, I mean,
throws that nade. That's a good nade.
He didn't cook it.
No, it denies the revive, and it was actually a smoke.
Okay.
What's he going to do? No first aids. Oh, he's got his bandages.
Yeah,
he's going
to
press it. He knows he can't let that player get a free revive. He's going to go aggressive. He's trying to juke him out and shimmy him out, pressure him out, but he sticks that revive. That player is 1 HP.
Brain on that other beast, though.
This fight, though, is still raging on, and the circle is about to close. Pappy, of course, if anyone's going to open the fight, it will be Pappy. Getting one onto Koops, too. Koops, we hype him up so much on EFC, and Pappy, just like that, bop, you're
out. On the back, though, HQA, Pappy, you got to watch out for that, because they are not done yet, and that is a huge spoiler for the Panthers. Oh, the worst case scenario. The second place team getting helped out by the last place team, HQA. And that's some big placement points that they're going to get just from having medkits. I mean, it's something that's a strategy a lot of other teams need to start looking closely at. That Molotov, you got to throw those right on top of that rock.
Yeah,
you can't throw it past him. Otherwise, it's going to go over his head all day long. G3, though, still trying to survive. The Knights have 9 kills. One more and they'll hit double digits. Look at memory. How many first aids left? Oh, no, there's 2 left. So it's getting pretty close. There goes Jay. Top 3, finish for Nova. 10 placement points at least. Just like that.
Man. The Knights, they pick up that kill onto Jason. It's top 2,
dude,
they get
top
Nova.
Two, 12 points.
It's second place.
Nuts.
Just.
Memory.
Zero kill points. You see that on the screen? Yep. Nova, 0 points. 0 kill points. Just first aiding. And
wow.
Boom. 12 points.
12 points.
0 to 12.
0 to 12. But guess what? Nova, with their performance so far, they ain't the team to talk about. The team we got to talk about is the Knights, baby, because the Knights have come in hot.